What is a codec, Carrie? Explain it to me. Exactly.
Robbie, I know you've told me before.
I'm not actually asking you to tell me. I'm just making a point that it's like, okay, well, what does it mean, right? In the olden days of computers, the file extension had a lot to do with what the file contained. So a .wav audio file was a .wave. It was a wave PCM file. So you always knew that it was that particular, you know, that was the information within the file because of the file extension. These days, video especially, you've got different containers now. So you've got an AVI file is no longer just an audio-video interleave. It's now what's called a container. And within that container, you can have XVID, you can have MP3 audio, you can have DIVX video, you can have, so it gets kind of confusing for a layperson who, you know, is trying to watch a video and is not able to bring it up on their computer and is getting, you know, the warning in Microsoft Windows Media Player saying that they can't play this because the codec isn't found and things like that.
Okay.
So just looking at Wikipedia for the technical term, a codec is a device or computer program capable of encoding and or decoding a digital data stream or signal. The word codec is a contraction, most commonly coder, decoder. So I guess technically it would be codec.
Codec.
That does not sound cool.
That doesn't sound cool.
So they went with codec. so a codec basically is what basically controls the compression of a video file or audio file or things like that. So within a video file, like you get an MP4, and same thing as the AVI, it could contain different types of streams. So with our RSS feeds, for example, you see that we have H.264 feeds. Well, that's an MP4 file or an M4V. So it gets really confusing. So on a Windows platform, on a Linux platform, you need to have those codecs installed, even on Mac. So with Linux, I created a nice little tool called the Perfect Ubuntu, and you can get that directly off of our website, category5.tv. It's not the only way to do it. It's just a really easy way to do it. So Perfect Ubuntu is available just by going to our website and hitting Resources, and then you'll find it under Linux Scripts. On Windows, on the other hand, you've got to get a codec pack. You've got to have the codecs installed to be able to access those video files or movies or anything, pardon me, at all within your Windows computer. So one of the things that we have to look at is we want to make sure that what we're doing is legal. So there's so many different codec packs out there, but there is one that claims that it is 100% legal. And so that's kind of one of the things that stands out to me, because that's one of the things that we want to have, is we don't want to have illegal software on our computer. And Windows, you know, tends to make it hard on us because everything costs so much money. So codecs from XP Codec Pack is available at xpcodecpack.com. And again, now I don't personally make any claims on this software, but they on the website do claim that it is 100% legal. You can see right here under features, 100% legal, 100% freeware, clean, compact, no spyware or adware, viruses or anything like that. And I've confirmed this. And so I am very happy to be able to recommend this software. So we're going to click on download over here. And once we click on download, now you'll see, first of all, I don't have this installed. And if I click on a downloaded video file that I've downloaded from our website, just an AVI copy of one of our shows on the Meet, it's going to ask me what to open it with. If you've got Windows Media Player installed, it's not going to, you know, it's probably not going to play because you don't have DIVX installed. So you can download that directly from this website, XP Codec Pack, currently 2.4.5. I've already downloaded it, so I'm just going to run it from my desktop and select English next. I'm going to tell it that I want to install all the video filters, all the audio filters, and all the tools. You can go through the list if you'd like to, but I want to have it all. And then I'm going to click next, let it install to the default location, and allow it to create shortcuts. And that's just going to go through a quick installation, and we'll be good to go. I'm just going to switch back to our codec installation here, Carrie, which is absolutely complete.
Mm-hmm.
Hit finish, and you'll see that it's added Media Player Classic to my desktop. So now if I double-click on that Category 5 file, it's added Media Player Classic to my recommended programs or to the list itself, and hit OK. Now, in this instance, I'm actually going to get a quick error because I've never installed a sound virtual sound driver into this computer. So I'm just going to... I get that, but you won't. So that will actually play that video just fine. There it is. So that's the video playing now that the codecs have been installed.
All right.
Excellent.